will likely spend your fair share of time in the sun before the summer ends, but that time can be damaging and dangerous for your skin. We welcome Dr. Khang Nguyen, dermatologist and assistant professor at UT Southwestern. And Dr. Nguyen, earlier in the hour, we talked about a new study suggesting that a higher SPF, higher than 50, may be more effective. Is that the case?
Well, you know, our position as dermatologists is that you want to be using at least an SPF 30 sunscreen. And actually, if applied properly, and for an adult, that's about a shot glass's worth of sunscreen to the entire body, there's not really that much of a difference in terms of protection from the UVB rays that are so harmful when you compare an SPF 50 or 100 sunscreen to an SPF 30. It's just important, I think it's very important that you apply properly and regularly.
So it's about staying on top of it. So that
exactly.
being said, how often should we be applying sunscreen?
I recommend to all your viewers and to my own patients to reapply every 2 hours.
Okay.
Sunscreen does get washed off. Certain sunscreens can get inactivated by the sun.
Okay, and does it impact how often we should apply if we're in the water? And how long should kids wait for that sunscreen to soak in before they dive into the water?
Yeah, absolutely. So you want to be choosing a sunscreen that's water resistant, especially if you're going to be spending time in or around water. For these sunscreens, apply and wait 10 to 15 minutes. Give it a chance to absorb before you jump in. So it can be hard to keep the little ones away from the pool. And as soon as you come out, I can't emphasize this enough, you want to reapply.
So stay on top of it. Another question that was interesting to me, are there products that can actually make you more vulnerable to burn?
Yes, unfortunately, people aren't aware of it, but a variety of prescription medicines, I can't name them all, but they include heart medicines, blood pressure medicines, antibiotics, even some pain relievers, and some medicines for treating cancer can make you sensitive to the sun. I recommend you talk to your doctor if you're going to be spending time outdoors and you have a new medicine and you're unsure if it can increase your risk for sunburn.
What about essential oils and maybe even perfumes, products like that?
Yeah, among personal products, there are ingredients that can sensitize you to the sun. One category of fragrances, people don't realize that. And also juices from, for example, citrus fruits like lemons and limes. They've been known to cause some pretty bad sunburns, streaky ones that people don't realize.
So we want to avoid all of that. But what happens if you do, in fact, get a burn? How do you treat it?
Well, the treatment is very simple. You're going to want to take some cool showers. You can take several during the course of a day to give some relief. Also, cool compresses where you take a towel and moisten it with cool water. Apply it to those really irritated areas. It can give you some relief. And also lotions containing aloe vera or soy can give a lot of relief. And lastly, if you're having a lot of discomfort, you can take ibuprofen, so long as you don't have any other medical issues that prevent you from taking it.
Got it. Dr. Nguyen, thank you so much for your time. We really do appreciate it. And if you missed any of these answers, we're going to post this segment on our website, cbsdfw.com.